On 90 Defiance Bears All, fans have learned a lot about 90 Defiance stars, sometimes more than they needed to know. But that isn't the only new 90 Defiance spin-off coming to Discovery+. Next month, 90 Day The Single Life premieres. Viewers will see an array of returning cast members whose on-screen relationships didn't work out the first time. Sean Robinson announced the spin-off on Sunday, January 24th, while addressing Discovery Plus subscribers. 90 Day The Single Life will follow Fernanda Flores, Brittany Banks, Molly Hopkins, Carl Johnson, Daniel Mullins, and Ed Brown. The spin-off premieres on February 21st. Though we do not yet have a full trailer, here is what we do know. Fernanda was a young adult in her late teens when she met Jonathan Rivera, who was on vacation and clubbing in Mexico City. The two hotties hit it off almost instantly, and John extended his vacation to spend more time with her. Despite the age gap, they opted to marry. But Fernanda was unhappy with their life in the US, and was specifically unhappy with how her new husband treated her after they married. They had a bitter divorce. Fernanda is still in the United States, living in Chicago, where she has been seen working as a high-end server and as a model. Despite her heartbreak, she eventually moved on and began to try dating over Zoom as the COVID-19 pandemic had begun. It'll be amazing to see what this young woman gets up to, but some haters will not exactly be rooting for her. Speaking of 90 Day Fiancé stars who have a lot of haters, Brittany Banks dated Yazan Ebo Horira for years before they were filmed. Unfortunately, being on camera changed so much about Yazan's behavior. Out of a desire to please his parents and fear of his extended family, he acted like a different person. Viewers saw very little love in their story. Instead, they showed Yazan's lies catching up with him as Brittany and his family realized that he had not been honest. Brittany clearly has a lot of hard feelings towards the man whom she was once prepared to marry. As a model and a rapper, she's going to have plenty of options as she tries to move on. But fans will be curious to see how her experience with Yazan alters how she views life as a single lady and as she tries out dating again. Molly Hopkins is part of a set of Georgian women who fell in love with much younger men from other countries. In her case, she was with Luis Mendez. It was a toxic marriage, it was short and it ended quickly. In fact, just a few months later, Luis remarried, which raised a lot of questions and eyebrows. Since then, Molly has endeared herself to fans and viewers on Pillow Talk. Fans are wondering what sort of life she's leading these days when she's not sharing her opinion on other stars. Will her next dates be age-appropriate, or is she once again dipping her toes into much younger waters? Carl Johnson is one of 90 Day Fiancé's most notorious villains, and cameras have followed his antics with two different women. With both Larissa Lima and Jess Caroline, Carl was quick to try to blame his mother Debbie for his doomed relationships. We might humbly suggest that perhaps the alleged mind games and the cheating had more to do with it than any MIL issues. What is interesting about Carl joining the show is that we already know how he moved on after Jess. First, he was with a very beautiful Mexican woman, on whom he reportedly cheated with Vanessa. Then he was with Vanessa. Which part of Colt's story will this follow, we don't know. Daniel Mullins is one of the stars who put the franchise on the map. Her marriage to Mohamed Jebali was must-watch television. They were both using each other. Daniel wanted a young lover, Mohamed wanted to come to America. They both got what they deserved, each other. Obviously, it ended in disaster, with Mohamed accusing Danielle of having a genital order and Danielle trying to get Mohamed deported. These days, she and Mohamed are actually friendly, but are not at all interested in remarrying. Danielle has moved on and is dating again, but fans are curious about, and suspicious of, which colorful characters are drawn to date such an eccentric personality. Speaking of colorful characters, Big Ed Brown is another 90 Day Fiancé villain who has been justifiably skewered by fans for his abhorrent treatment of Rosemary Vega. The guy is a creep, but he is also one of the most mean reality stars on the planet, which is saying a lot when you're talking about someone who was totally unknown before 2020. This means that contrary to previous fan speculations, Big Ed has not been banned from all 90 Day Fiancé spin-offs despite his gross behavior and a serious allegation of sexual assault. Why? Because TLC loves money. Unless advertisers pull out or there's a concentrated fan boycott, they'll err on the side of filming a famous dumbass, so long as he makes them money. 90 Day Fiancé blogger John Yates was the first to break the news over the summer that Ed was filming again, so now we know that backstory. That's it for now, thank you for watching, please subscribe to stay tuned.